Hello friends, in this video you will watch about webcam. Webcams get the job done for the live streaming and video conferencing. But what if there was something better? There is. With just a few cable and some free software, you can easily turn your DSLR camera into a webcam. Improve the quality of your live streams, video chats and webinars. In this video you will watch how can I use Nikon DSLR as a webcam. Your Nikon camera may already be equipped with the features that will allow it to be connected for the high quality video streaming through software and or hardware. It will be possible with the Nikon webcam utility setup. Let's start. First, you need to open your explorer and type Nikon webcam utility. You will find first link of the downloader page. Click the link. Webcam utility page will open. You can see here a link named software. Open the link by clicking your mouse button. Here are two options, first for the Windows and second for the Mac. I have Windows computer, so I am selecting Windows option. Is your camera is compatible for this or not? You need to select the system requirement link. You can see here the compatible cameras. If your camera is in the list, click on the accept button for the agreement and then select the regional server area to download. Then click on the download button. Software will be started download to your default download location of your computer. After completing the download, I am installing the software. After installation, the driver will be added in the Windows system automatically. To check it, I am opening Streamlabs software that mostly I use for live streaming. First, you need to add source video capture device. After adding video capture device, click on the video capture device option. A new setting window will pop up. The first menu is a device drop-down menu. Normally, it will show your default webcam device, but now you will find a new device, Nikon Webcam Utility. You can easily see the webcam window on the streaming view panel. You can adjust the display and location of video capture screen. You can also transform this screen to fit to full screen. Now your computer is set to receive the output via your camera. It is a time to set your camera to transmit the video to Streamlabs software. You need three hardware to use your camera as a webcam. Your DSLR, either cable or USB cable, tripod or any stable camera stand. Connect your Nikon camera to your computer using the USB cable that was included with your camera. As I connect the USB cable and select the web utility from device drop-down menu, camera live display will be off and you will see the video in your live streaming screen. If you are using zoom lens with your camera, you can zoom your lens to compose your picture. You can't do the same with your inbuilt webcam. I am again selecting my inbuilt camera and you can see me in the screen. As I am selecting the Nikon webcam utility, you can see the computer via my camera because my camera is with me and I fixed it in front of my computer. You can select any angle or any focal length with your DSLR. That is not possible with your fixed focal length webcam. For live streaming or live chat, you need to place the camera in front of you. So I am fixing my camera to tripod that place in front of me. You can see the chair from the DSLR because I am not here. I am setting the camera. After fixing the camera on tripod, I am sitting on the chair, but you are not able to see my face. So I set my tripod again on the level of my chest. You can also set the same settings or on any web streaming site like StreamYard.com. You can see the front view via default webcam, also able to see the both cameras device on the settings. As I select the Nikon webcam utility, you can see the view from my camera. I have set roughly here, you can adjust according to your composition. One thing you need before setting your camera, your battery should be fully charged and you need to set your angle of view, focal length and focus before connecting your camera to software. I used Nikon camera You can also use any Sony, Canon or any make camera with USB cable, but your camera should be compatible according to the system requirements of that company. Basics are same, software and cameras are different according to the camera company. Hope you like the video. If you have any question, don't hesitate to ask. I will answer all of your questions. Don't forget to subscribe my channel so you can see my latest video. That's all for the today. Soon I will come with the new tutorial. Thanks for watching.